Hello dear viewers, welcome to this video. Today I will talk about Arduino OPC server, which is essential for developing Arduino based SCADA system. Arduino OPC server is a software application that runs on PC Windows system and provides a standard interface to connect Arduino to any OPC compliant SCADA software. In this video I will show you the process for downloading, installing and configuring of this OPC server, which will be helpful for you to build Arduino based SCADA system. And finally I will take you through the process for testing this OPC server using a Windows based test tool, DOPC Explorer. So let's get started. Before to start, first you have to install OPC core components on the PC Windows system if you want to build your Arduino based SCADA system on that PC. These core components will enable all the OPC servers and the SCADA softwares to work or run properly on the PC Windows system. If Arduino OPC server and the SCADA user interface runs on different PCs, to make network based SCADA system, you have to install this OPC core components on all pieces of this network. To get and download the OPC core components file, a direct link has been provided in my video description box. After downloading, you will come to get this file in zip format. So unzip it or extract this file to get the setup file, and you can easily install this program from this setup file. This has already been installed on this PC. Go to control panel and launch the programs and features file to get the list of programs installed on this PC. Note that OPC core components redistributable has already been installed on this PC. Now proceed for downloading and configuring for Arduino OPC server. It is a free software which you can get from the website address st4makers.com, or you can get it from the link given in the video description box. If you want to get it from the website, access to this website page by writing the address st4makers.com in the search bar of your browser and come to get this website page. Note that there is a button for downloading this OPC server, and you can easily download this OPC server by clicking on this button. I have already downloaded this file and I have come to get this file in zip format when I downloaded it. Zip this file to get three other files in total. Now what can we do is to make a new folder and choose a name for this folder, Arduino OPC server. Arduino OPC server. Now move all these three extracted files to this folder. From now we will configure and run this OPC server every time from this folder. Now move to main program file, Arduino OPC server.x, and double click on it. The program for Arduino OPC server executed, and now it is running on the PC, which can be visible as an icon in the system tray. At the same time, two other files, registered.bat and unregistered.bat, appeared in the window. Now what we have to do is to make a proper configuration for this OPC server. That is, we have to make proper communication settings for this server so that Arduino connected to this PC will properly communicate with this server. So to make configuration, click on the server icon to get the full window. This window shows three tabs: information, configuration and info. Go for configuration tab. Under this tab, there are options to set configuration for serial or Ethernet communication. If you connect your Arduino to the PC by a simple USB cable, there will be established a serial communication between the Arduino and the OPC server. So click on the button for Arduino serial. You will get Arduino.serial0. On the right side, you will get options to make settings for serial port. Here we have to select which USB port or COM port of this PC we are using to connect USB cable coming from the Arduino. The USB cable from Arduino has been plugged in COM port 3 of this PC. So select COM 3, leave other settings just as same. Now click on the button for save configuration to save these settings. This completes the settings for configuration of Arduino OPC server. Now minimize this window. Note that there have been created a new file, Arduino OPC server.ini. All configuration settings that we have made earlier have been saved in this file. Every time we will execute Arduino OPC server.x, it will start to run with this configuration settings. Once you have finished your configuration settings for OPC server, one more task you have to do is to register this OPC server with the Windows operating system. Registering this OPC server will enable any OPC compliant SCADA software to find this server and connect it as its data source. This can be done by double clicking on the file register.bat. So run the bash file register.bat. Arduino OPC server has been now registered with the Windows operating system. You can also unregister the OPC server from the bash file unregister.bat. Our OPC server is now ready to communicate with Arduino, retype the input-output data from the Arduino, and able to provide this data to any OPC compliant SCADA user interface. Now I will perform a test for Arduino OPC server using a OPC test tool, DOPC Explorer. The test arrangement has been done by connecting a push button switch to Arduino digital pin number 8, a LED to Arduino digital pin number 12, and a variable register to Arduino analog input pin A0. Our next step is to connect Arduino to PC by USB cable and make a proper OPC case for Arduino. For this test arrangement, I have already made the required OPC case and loaded this case to Arduino. Take a look at this case and note that 3 OPC tags have been declared for these 3 devices connected to Arduino input-output pin. The purpose is to test whether the Arduino OPC server running on the PC will be able to publish these tags or items to any OPC compliant SCADA client. DOPC Explorer is a such type of diagnostic and test tool which browses for any OPC servers running on the PC and also browses for the tags or item published by this OPC server. You can also watch the values of these tags using this DOPC Explorer. To work with DOPC Explorer, you have to download and install it on your PC. You can get it from this link, or a direct download link for this OPC test tool has been provided in my video description box. After installation, I have come to get this program file for DOPC Explorer. Connect Arduino to PC and run the Arduino OPC server. Arduino OPC server has started to run on this PC. Go for program DOPC Explorer and execute it to run this test tool on the PC. This test tool is now open and ready to make proper settings so that it can communicate with the Arduino OPC server. Go for file menu and click on the new server button to get the dialog box for Add Office Server. Under Com tab, browse for the computer name. The computer name selected here actually refers to the name of the PC on which your Office server is running. Now browse for the available Office servers from this PC by clicking on Find button. Here you will get a list of Office server running on this PC. Now select Office server for Arduino Genuino and click on OK button to close this. Arduino Office server has now added to this test tool. Now right click on Office server for Arduino and click on Connect button to connect it. The DOPC Explorer has now started to communicate with Arduino to share Arduino input output data. To browse for the OPC items from the Arduino, click on Object button. All the OPC items from the Arduino have been appeared on the right side. Now to us the value for this OPC items, we have to create a group and add this OPC items to this group. Now right click on Groups and click on New Group to get the dialog box for Add Group. Give the name for this group Arduino and set the update rate to 1000 milliseconds. Setting this, the tag value will update after every 1000 milliseconds. Leave other settings just as same. Now click on OK button to close this. A new group Arduino has been created. Add the OPC items to this group. Go for Add Items dialog box. Select the desired OPC items and click on OK buttons to close this. Items have been added to these groups. Activate this group and now you will find the real-time value for this OPC items or tags which refers to the actual input-output condition for this Arduino. Now change the input-output status of Arduino and see how these values for OPC tags change with the operation of input-output devices connected to the Arduino. So that's all about the procedure for configuration of Arduino Office server and testing this Office server with Office Test Client DOFC Explorer. If you watch and find this video effective for you, please like, share, comment and subscribe to this channel.